We're here today at Knott's Berry Farm for the Taste of Boysenberry Festival. This is our first time at this event, so let's check it out and see what they have to offer. So right now we have the Boysenberry Elote and this Boysenberry Cucumber Pineapple Agua Fresca. I love elotes. It's like one of my all-time favorite foods, so I am so excited to try this right now. So it has a boysenberry mayo with cotija cheese and butter. Oh. That's different. No, not in a bad way. It has like a sweet taste to it because of the boysenberry, but it tastes like, you know, your regular elote with the butter and cheese, but just that hint of sweetness with the boysenberry. I didn't think it would taste good, honestly, because it looks pretty, but sometimes the prettiest looking things don't always taste the best. This is actually tasty. I would get it again. I wouldn't get it all the time, but it tastes like a dessert, honestly. Still tasty. Let's try this agua fresca. Ooh. This is so refreshing.
What is it?
It's a boysenberry pineapple cucumber agua fresca. You wanna try it?
Yeah.
The boysenberry honestly tastes, you can taste more of the boysenberry in the elote than you can in the drink. This one, I think because it's mixed with the cucumber and pineapple, it kind of mixes the flavors. So the boysenberry isn't as strong, but the boysenberry, you can really taste it in this.
Elite.
You have to try this.
I will.
It's like, I've never had an elote like this before, but I do like it. It is.
Two thumbs up.
Yeah. Try it and see what you think. I inhaled that elote. It was so good. The more I ate it, the more I really enjoyed it. But there are so many offerings. I mean, look at this. It's ridiculous. I thought there would be like a few items at each, you know, each area, but there are so many options and we're just having a hard time deciding what we want to eat because there's so many things we want to try. What's nice is, you know, with the tickets, $45 for adults and you get 5 tastings with a tasting card. For kids, it's like 3 tastings, but it was $8.40 for the price of this agua fresca. It was $8.40 for the price of the elote. So you really do get your money's worth here. And you are able to use your tasting for both food and alcohol. So can't wait for the sangria later.
My goodness, you ladies are making me jealous. Yes, you'll have to enjoy all your goodies for me today. I'd love to join you, but I'm here on official business, you know. Mm-hmm. Well, are we keeping her out of trouble? Yes. Staying on our best behavior, I hope.
So here we have the boysenberry sangria and the boysenberry brisket mac and cheese. And this was $8.50. That's not a bad price for the amount of sangria you get. So cheers, let's try it out. Ooh. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Tastes kind of strong though.
Definitely tastes the boysenberry actually.
Yeah. Let's try this mac and cheese. I've been looking forward to this mac and cheese. Especially since we weren't able to get brisket at the at Disneyland's Touch of Disney. Oh, that is good. That is good brisket. Oh wow. I'm gonna take another bite because the brisket, it's like that boysenberry adds a little sweetness to it, but the brisket, the meat is so soft. Oh gosh. You better have some of this before I finish it.
Yeah.
That meat is so soft. Try it.
So definitely recommend it?
Definitely recommend it. That is really good. Oh, yeah. That is so good. Oh my gosh. I definitely want more of that. But the boysenberry isn't overpowering in the meat. It's like a nice, subtle, like you can definitely taste the boysenberry, but it's not so strong. Try a little bit more.
Oh, that's really good.
Yeah. Mm.
I actually like it with the little green onions there.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Did you get more of that brisket?
I'm going to again.
Yeah, that meat is really good. Would you recommend it?
Yeah, definitely. Oh yeah, there's the boysenberry. That's really good.
Mm-hmm. Mm. So far, liking everything we've tried so far.
Let's see what's next.
So it's been a few years since I've been to Knott's, and this is our first trip together, actually. But I love that it's pretty empty, so there's plenty of room to walk around and really social distance. It was crowded at a Touch of Disney, and it could be because, you know, we went on a, you know, during spring break, but I love how empty it is today. It gives us plenty of room to walk around and really enjoy without worrying about being around too many people.
I don't know them personally, Rue, was there anything negative on the savory safari?
Unfortunately, yes.
So here we have the boysenberry Dippin' Dots. It's very berry. It tastes like candy almost.
It's like a very strong berry flavor.
Yeah. I don't know how I feel, but I'm not a big berry person when it comes to ice cream. So it's good. But would I personally get it again? I personally probably won't. But it is tasty, just not my favorite. Mm. It does taste like candy though.
You want to share so I can get my own.
That's... I don't like to share ice cream. I don't.
Okay. Well, let's get down to it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So here we have the Mexican street corn chowder with boysenberry tortilla chips. Let's try the. Mmm. Ooh. There's like a nice little kick to it.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, very good.
Now I do taste the juice.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Taste the chip.
Let me try the chip. Ooh, you can really taste the boysenberry in this chip. But it's good. Let me dip it in the soup. Mmm. Yeah, you can definitely taste it, but it's really good with the chowder. I think it pairs really well. Wanna try it?
Yeah, let me try it. All right, so I guess I'll give this a try. Get some of that cheese. Oh yeah, a little kick. Good though, wow.
Did you try the tortilla chip?
No.
Could really taste the boysenberry.
Wow. You put a lot of boysenberry in that chip.
Yeah.
Oh, this is really good.
Would you recommend it?
Two thumbs up, for sure.
There's Charlie Brown. Not expecting to see any, like, actual Peanuts characters, so that was a nice surprise.
Yeah, it was.
So cute how they decorated the Camp Snoopy section. So we're about done for the day. We're just getting our boysenberry pie, so we can't leave without that. But it's been a great experience so far, and they advertise it kind of like a marketplace, and that's exactly how it feels. There's vendors. I mean, right behind me, there's this blacksmith. They have a lot of food stands, and it's, yeah, really great how spaced out everything is, but still offering so much.
I actually kind of like it better than Disneyland.
Yeah, the food overall, I mean, even though everything was like boysenberry themed, overall, I say like food-wise, it's better. I mean, we got a second serving of the brisket mac and cheese. It was that good. It was so savory, and the boysenberry wasn't overpowering at all, so we had to get another bowl. But yeah, compared to the food at Disneyland, yeah, I'd say this one is better. I would love to come back for another event if they have it in the future and try like other foods that aren't all boysenberry.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's been a great day so far.
Yeah, with that pie.
Yes. So the moment we've been waiting for, the boysenberry pie. That is good pie. I always like my pie with ice cream, but we have whipped cream, which is good, but I always prefer my pie with ice cream. Still tastes very good. We also couldn't help ourselves and got the red velvet bundt cake with a boysenberry cream cheese frosting. Looks so cute. Let me try this. This is really good.
Which is better?
They're different.
If you only buy one, what would it be?
Oh, it depends on my mood, I guess. Like,
if you only buy one, what is it gonna be?
I would have to say the pie. Oh. Just because, you know, you don't get boysenberry pie every day. And so this, I think, is like one of the must items to get here. This bundt cake is still really good, but nothing I would like come back for all the time. Yeah. The pie is something I would come back for every time I'm here. I mean, you try it and let me know what you think.
That's pretty good. Yeah, well, that cream would be super good.
Yeah, with ice cream.
Pretty rich though, and you can definitely taste the boysenberry. I mean, I bit into a chunk of boysenberry. Well, let's try the red velvet. Red velvet is my favorite. This is what I wanted, so. Definitely lighter as far as the boysenberry flavor. But I don't know if I like better.
Yeah,
I like the pie.
It does have the lighter boysenberry taste. Yeah, I think because the cake itself has so much flavor.
I think if the pie had ice cream.
Oh yeah, if the pie had ice cream, it would be a no-brainer for me.
Vanilla. Oh,
man. Yeah. They had the boysenberry crisp that came with a vanilla ice cream.
That sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
If maybe I were next choose time. One. Yeah, I'd probably go the pie as a must-have. You don't get this very often. I can get good red velvet right where we live, so definitely the pie.
Okay, good to know. Man, I'm stuffed. We ate so much today, but everything was really good. I mean, we finished our dessert. Overall, it was a great event. There weren't a lot of people. There was a lot of food options and a lot of vendors, and there was plenty of space to walk around. So definitely recommend the Taste of Boysenberry Festival at Knott's Berry Farm. Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video and want to see other videos like this, please like and subscribe to our channel.